Hey guys, how you doing? It's AD here for the explorographer.com, and we're here on our very second, I think this is our second Patreon event. I can't see what you guys, if you guys are hanging out with me right now, I know that we got some viewers out there. I can't see you right now, but when I turn around to actually work on the camera, which I have back here, you guys can see it there in the corner. We're going to be working on a camera tonight, and I want to talk a little bit about some of the cameras that you guys always see behind me now. Some of them I purchased when I've been on the road. Some of them have personal meaning, like I had them when I was younger, and it was a chance for me to find them again. And I love cleaning these things up. I know that, you know, a lot of people like to just leave them the way they are, but I like to clean them up. But in this case, with the Richoflex, I am really freaking out over actually being able to use this camera because it's in exceptionally good shape. So it shoots in a square format. If you're not familiar with this type of camera, it's the type of box camera that you look down into from the top. It's very popular with street photographers. It kind of is responsible, because of a square format, it's kind of responsible for the whole Instagram. So if you kind of make that connection with the two. So what I'm going to be doing is taking the camera apart. I'm going to be cleaning as much of it as I possibly can. And then after we're done, you guys can let me know in the chat if you guys want to hang out and ask questions. We can take it to a personal hangout, not on the air, and you guys can hang out. So, all right. Well, I hope you guys are hearing this okay. I'm going to switch on the other camera, and we're going to start working on the Richoflex, and we'll talk a little bit about that. So I'm going to switch and turn around, see if this works. We'll see. There we go. All right. So you guys should be seeing the camera now, camera number two, and I'm going to turn around. Hopefully I won't knock anything down. There we go. All right. So I have actually a chat window here that I can actually talk to you guys. So I can see what's going on the camera. There's a little bit of a delay, but I can see what you guys type in the chat over on YouTube. And if you have questions as I'm going, I'm going to try to glance over and try to answer the questions. So we picked this camera up for relatively cheap. I think it was maybe $35 or something like that. The lenses look immaculate. I'm going to hold this up nice and close to the camera so that you guys can see, but the lenses look really good. There's a little bit of spots on here, but this is on the outside. Actually, the inside looks really good, but we're going to open it up and look at all that. There's some, you know, dirt and dust here. I'm going to be concentrating on that. There's some dust around here. And then we have the viewfinder here. So cool. I mean, this is just so much fun. And so we look down through into the viewfinder. That is quite dirty in there. So we're going to be working on that. And yeah. So like I said, you have any questions, you guys, along the way, please put them in the chat, and I will try to answer them. So, very cool camera. I'm really super excited. I'm going to be going out west this summer, and I want to take this with me with a whole bunch of film, and I'm going to take a lot of photos with it, so I'm excited to use it. So, all right, well, let's get started on tearing this thing apart. So, the very first thing that I want to take apart, you notice there's some dirt here. I might not be able to get that off, but we're going to try. The very first thing I'm going to do is actually take the film cartridge out. So we're going to slide that off to the side. Just really cool tripod mount on here too. Now, this is not a very expensive medium format camera. This is kind of on the cheaper end of the scale, but that kind of makes it all the more cool, I think. So, all right, so we got that. We'll open the back. Here's the inside of the camera. So it took me a little bit to figure out exactly how to get into this thing and pull it apart. I've never had one of these before. I've always seen them, always wanted one, but didn't really understand how to get them apart. But I figured it out pretty quick. You pull on this, so you pull that out, and this whole film, and there's actually a roller in here, which is pretty rare, I guess, to have a roller there. So you pull all that out, and we have access to the actual film lens there. So we're going to set this aside for now. This is pretty clean. It looks pretty good. So there's not much that I'm going to do with this part, the film carriage, but I'm going to be working on this part of the camera, especially the viewfinder. Viewfinder is really dirty. And the back of the lens looks pretty good. I'm looking at it in the light here, and that lens is actually looking pretty spotless. So I might not touch that. If it's clean, we don't usually do anything with it. There's no sense. All the mechanics, by the way, on this camera, the shutter, took me a while to figure that out and how to work all that. But everything on here works. So that's kind of a nice feature as well, that you can actually, it actually will work. So you see that we've got a shutter speed here. It's on bulb right now, but if I turn it like to a 100 shutter speed, my little indicator right there, I don't know if you guys can see that, but it's right there. The camera will focus. I can't tell if it's focused or not, so hopefully it is for you guys. But if I push this down, up, and it arms, and this is set to, let's see, 50, that means it's going to be 1/50th. So if you watch the shutter in there when I press down on this, that was it. Shutter opens and closes that quick. So pretty cool. All that works really well. I actually have a, this is a flash trigger, I believe, and I also have a trigger, a hand trigger, shutter release that actually works with this. So I was really thrilled about that, and that plugs in right there. So, all right, let's see. What do I want to do first? Let's clean the front lenses first. I'm going to just use a basic lens pen. Excuse me. And if I have to go more than this, then I'm going to break out the methanol, and we'll go with that. But I'm just going to see if I can get this to clean off for me. So actually, you know what? I'm going to wet clean it first. A little pad here, and we're going to put a little methanol on this, and I'm going to clean that lens. Let's do that first. Sure, if you're out there and hanging out with me, that you say hello. I see we've got 4 people viewing over on YouTube. You can open up the chat and talk. So feel free to type in the chat because I'm watching for you guys. Hopefully you're hearing me. Everything is on. I'm going to check my mic. Yeah, my mic says that we've got level, so I hope we have level. If you're out there and you're listening, let me know if we have level. So if you don't answer me, pretty much know that it's probably not working. So look at all that. We got some dust and some stuff off there. So that's nice. Generally, when I do a pass with one of these, that's it. I don't try to do it again. I'm just going to do one pass because I don't want to grind the dirt back in there after I do a nice job cleaning stuff off. Looking at that spot that's on there, that spot did not come off, and that's not good. It might mean that it's some sort of mold or mildew in there. And it might be on the inside. I doubt it, though. But we'll see. This is an 80mm lens. This methanol that I'm using is very good at cleaning lenses. And it's very safe for coated lenses. These are coated, and they look great. So you can see there's quite a bit of stuff coming off there. Look. All right, so, hey, there we go. We're watching on Patreon. Cool to see. Not something totally you would do. Yeah, absolutely, Lori. I mean, you know, I always used to think that too, and I'll tell you something that's interesting, is that it can sit on the shelf and it won't work otherwise, or I can break it, and it's still not going to work, right? So I'm like, what the heck? Why not try, right? I mean, you never know. This camera, you know, before I decided, I did a lot of looking over of the actual camera itself. And I just want to make sure, too, Lori, I see you're out there. Are you hearing me okay? Just type in the box there and let me know if you're hearing me okay. So for me, it's a kind of a do or die thing, you know? It's either it's going to work or it's not. And if it doesn't, then it becomes just a shelf sitter. Now these lenses look great, but that spot that I was seeing might just be a shadow. It's pretty good. Although it looks like it might be on the back side of the lens now that I'm looking close at it. So that might require a little bit. All right, awesome. Thank you very much for letting me know. This might require a little bit of surgery to do the backside element. And I'm willing to try that with you guys. What the heck, right? But there's some screws here on the side, some set screws. You guys can see those right there. There's one there, one there. There should be 3 usually. and one there. There you go. Most lenses are set up like this. So once you see my pile of lenses over here, I do take them apart and try to learn about how they work and how the mechanisms work. And a lot of them only cost me, you know, $25-$30. So it's worth learning, I think, to try to tear them apart. This one I'm afraid of because I don't want to break it because I'm looking forward to using it. So if it gets too complicated once I take those screws out, I probably won't continue. I'll just put them back and stop. But let's do the viewfinder first before we get into that. I just wanted to clean the front of those off just to get them looking a little better. So I see four screws here and a nameplate. And the nameplate's got screws in it too. Isn't it so nice that things today, or things back then, you could actually take them apart? Things today are made so you can take them apart. And the reason why they do that is because they don't want you to steal their ideas. And if you can take it apart, you can reverse engineer it. And if you can reverse engineer it, then basically you can steal it. So they don't want that. So there's the nameplate off there. Let me clean that up a little bit. It looks pretty good, though. Normally, actually, let me pause for just a second. I don't think I have my... Let me see if I... yes, I do. Awesome. Okay. I have this cool little thing right here, this thing. And what this is just a magnetic pad. And it keeps my screws from going bye-bye. And I keep them in little squares so I know what's what. So if I want to, I can, you know, label this faceplate or whatever, but I can usually remember pretty well. So a little bit of dirt and stuff in here. I'm going to do the cosmetic stuff last once it's apart. So go ahead and take these top screws off because this is going to release the nice thing about this, too, is these screws are all kind of loose. So they probably need to be tightened down a little bit. And that'll kind of, that'll be a nice tightening it up before I use it, you know, making sure everything works nice. So I hope you guys enjoy this. This is what I call fun, taking things apart and playing with them. I do this a lot whenever I can. I don't have as much time as I used to have to do this sort of thing. You guys, some of you know my story of making my own infrared camera. That I have actually right here. I have two of them actually. So, but I took an old Sony A55 and I took the sensor out and put a new IR glass that I cut from an old IR filter and put the camera back together and I have an IR camera. The camera didn't work. It was just sitting around. It had a broken LCD. So I'm like, what the heck? Let's play with it. Let's see what happens. So turns out I get a lot of use out of it. I love taking infrared shots. It's just a way to break the creative woes sometime. Yeah. All right. So there's that. And that will take, oh, look at that. So that's the whole viewfinder piece there. You can see the springs. I want to just observe what happens when I open this. I'm going to open it and just observe what those springs do. There we go. Okay, so they kind of bounce up and they stay latched. So I probably won't take this apart. I can gain access to all of that, the viewfinder I can do, and I can also, I got the backside now that I can clean. Although this is frosted. And I want to make sure that I don't hurt that. So we'll take a closer look at that in a second. It does look like it's fairly easy to take these clips out and actually pop that out. But I'm probably going to try to clean it in there. So a few little things over here where it's been little chips or it's maybe been dropped or something. So that's interesting. We're going to go ahead and essentially what I'm going to do is clean all these parts. So we'll do that next. But I'm looking right here, and I see where a lot of my dirt is. And if you guys look straight down, I'm not sure if you can see that, but that mirror, I'll tilt it back and forth. That mirror, this is where you look down. And the way this works, the way this camera works, is you look down through the viewfinder. And as you move this lens to focus, it focuses the bottom lens. And the actual photo and mechanism is actually taken through only the bottom lens. So this is like your viewfinder lens, and then this is your actual lens that takes the shot. So you can see that mirror is pretty dirty. So instead of touching that mirror, which I don't want to do, I'm actually going to walk away from the desk here real quick. You guys should still be able to hear me just fine. I can untangle my mic cord, or it'll either unplug everything when I try to do this, or it'll actually work. So I think it'll work. I'm going to step away here real quick and grab a blower so that I can clean that. There we go. All right. That wasn't too bad, I think. I'm using a different mic tonight. It probably sounded a little bit different. I'm not using the big microphone because I had to move around during this broadcast. The first time I've done a dual camera setup like this. So, it has to kind of be this way in order for me to show you guys this. So all right. So what we're going to do is I'm going to blow that dust out of there real quick. And we're just going to let it rip and get some off the back. Looks like there's a little bit inside. Boy, the back of this lens looks really good, the top lens for sure. Not sure I'm going to be touching much of that. A little mark here and there, so we'll see. It's going to be difficult to get to because of the angle that it's at. And I don't really want to, I don't think I want to try to take it out of there. I could completely disassemble this entire camera. You see the mirror comes out quite easily. So we'll go ahead and we'll clean that, put that back in. But I'm pretty sure that taking this piece out, this is all welded in. Yeah, so I don't think I want to try to take that out. So the only recourse would be to try to take this off, which it will come off. Actually, this whole assembly will come off, I think, with just these four screws. So we might entertain that. There's some pretty big dirt in there. All right, so let's clean this. We're going to use, boy, look at that. That's magnetic. It's holding on there pretty good. So that's kind of dirty, but that's okay. It's just a spring, so we're not going to worry about that too much. All right, so I'm going to We're getting deep now. I'm going to take another one of my pads, and I'm going to this time put some methanol right on the mirror. We're going to use that to clean that mirror all spiffy like. I really wish that I could show you guys before and after as far as looking through the viewfinder. I'm only going to be able to see that, but you all will be able to see the photos later on and how the photos that this takes, because I will be sharing them. So, this might be, I'm pretty sure that this is going to be a stepping stone to a nicer medium format camera. because I'm pretty sure that I will be hooked on taking some photos with this. Now, this is a very cheap and expensive mirror, I have to say. Not very good. And that's part of why the camera is probably less expensive than, most. So, all right. So I think what we'll do is we're just going to set this aside. That's magnetic. We're just going to set it right there before we put it back in. And we're going to try taking this front off. So let's do this. We're going to take these screws out here. So what Lori was talking about, this is where it starts to get a little bit more daring, okay? We have to kind of keep track. It looks like these screws might be a little different from the other ones. And the deeper you go, the more there is to keep track of, right? So it is one of the things that I am actually fairly blessed with when I take things apart. Oh, yeah, look at that. That's going to come right out. So that's cool. That will come off the front of the camera, and I'll have access to the backside of that top lens. And I'm going to clean that. So let's go ahead and do that. Then we'll decide what we're doing about that bottom lens. I think that's a good time to do that. But this is the part where, people like, how deep do I go before I I can't remember how to put it back together. Always use your phone or something to videotape what you're doing while you're working on stuff like this. And you just watch it back. You know, there, you have all these tools. You've got cameras. You take cameras. You got a camera that I'm sure shoots video if you have a phone. So there we go. That's the whole lens piece off now. So I can see the aperture blades here in the back. I can actually take this apart. This will unscrew off the back of the camera. I usually have to have a special wrench, but I'm sure I could figure out how to do that. There are some spots on the back of the viewfinder that I'm seeing. I'm going to hold this up to the light away from you guys for just a second, just so I can view through the lens. Oh, yes, it's covered with spots. So I'm going to show you what that looks like. This is going to be very bright. So you're in a dark room. You might want to look away. But I'm going to put a light behind this. And you guys should be able to see if it focuses properly. And I can't tell you whether it's going to or whether it's not. But there's quite a bit of the dirt on the back of that lens. All right, so we're going to clean that for sure. This is called a loop, by the way. And it's used like this normally. And I would zoom in. Maybe you guys can see it like that. But it's used usually to inspect a sensor to make sure that the sensor is clean. And I kind of, whoops, I kind of looked straight down on the sensor with that. So yeah, that was bright. I'm looking at it now. Sorry about that, guys. All right. So we're going to clean the back of that off. And I'm making a pile here and it's getting bigger. So I'll tell you what we're going to do. We don't need that over there. Yeah, you can definitely see it that way a little bit better. I don't know. Lori, you know, Lori asks if the Fujifilm GFX 50S is a medium format camera. You know, I don't know. I am so new to this whole thing, this whole part of it, that I don't know. That's a good question. I'm just starting to learn myself. So this is the very beginning. You guys, I'm sharing with you guys the beginnings of my discovery. Boy, that was really messy in there. See if I can. I think I can use the back side. Still clean. We'll use it to clean the bottom one. So these are special pads. They're called PEC pads. They're specifically designed not to hurt coatings on lenses. The same thing with the lens pens. They have a special carbon coating on them, and they do a really good job. I rarely have to clean my lenses. Once they're cleaned with a lens pen, I normally just have to blow dust off them. Yes. I was just, Karen wants me to come and install flooring at her house. I don't know how that's going to work out. I told her, I said I love her, but not that much. So yeah, that's what I've been doing all day is installing flooring. So there we go. So wow, look at that. I'll show you guys. That came out pretty good. Still got some, it looks like it's still got some mildew on it. So I might be scrubbing a little bit more. Now keep in mind, that's the viewfinder. The actual lens itself, you guys can see that. The actual lens is pretty clean. And I think that what I can do, show you this little trick. I don't know if it's going to work or not. You can usually put an LED up behind the lens and focus it. And you can actually see where the dirt spots are. This has still got quite a bit of dirt on it. But the good thing is that the actual shooting part of the camera is very clean. So I'll do a little bit more. But I am definitely not going to be upset about the viewfinder. That's just no reason to really worry about that. So you can get these cleaning pads if you decide to want to delve into this sort of thing. These cleaning pads are available from Copper Hill Imaging. They're called PEC pads. I think they're available on Amazon and everywhere else too. So you probably just don't have to just get them from them. This time I'm going to scrub a little bit harder. See if I can get any of that off there. And while it's still wet, I'm going to grab the lens pen real quick. The lens pen is treated with a carbon, which is really good for getting certain types of mildew and things off lenses. So we'll see if that helps a little bit. Swear by these things. I use them all the time. So let's just take a look. What we got there. Yeah. So we still have some spots. But overall, that looks pretty clean. Most of them are spots that are reflections internally from the LED. So that looks really nice. I'm just going to clean this back one more time. We still have to tackle that front one that's got a spot on it. So take a closer look at that. I don't like to use compressed air. I'll tell you, it usually has a liquid in it that makes it go, and the liquid gets very cold, and sometimes the liquid comes out, and it gets on things, and it damages things. So I don't like to use that spray stuff. I just rather human power stuff works much better. Looks like this faceplate is actually made out of copper. That's pretty cool. All right. Looks pretty good. I'm going to use the loop really quick and off screen. I apologize. I have to put it up to my eye. I need to know if this spot is something I can work on. So let me just look really quick. Okay, so there's a pretty good spot on this lens. I don't know if I can show you guys that. I don't know if you can see that or not. I'll wait till the video goes on, but there is a spot on the lens. And it looks like it's on the front. So I'm going to scrub it a little bit more and see if I can get that to come off. It looks to me like some sort of chemical or something hit it, and it's been there for a long time, which very well could be. And that stuff sometimes is really difficult to get off the camera. Just scrub down on it a little bit harder this time. I don't have to open up the lenses to do work, I will not do that. So, wow, there's a lot of grime on there. So let me just see if that got any of that. Boy, it looks like it did. Got a little bit of it. So there's still a very little bit. It almost looks like someone's fingerprint, if you can believe it. It really does. So I'm going to do something I normally don't do, which this guy. I'm going to put a little bit of this on here. I'm going to make it stick to it because these things don't like liquid. They usually suck up the liquid. I'm going to just see what I can get off that. We're so close. I get that lens so it doesn't have anything on it, that'd be real nice. Certainly looks a lot better than when we started, that's for sure. $35, I mean, pretty good looking optics for that price. Let's take a look. And there we go. That's a win. So there's still some dust on there. I have to blow that off, obviously, but that spot is gone. We got it. Yeah, that's completely gone. So that's a win. We don't have to open up the lens. All the mechanics work really well on this, so I don't really have to do anything with that. Everything looks good there. So we got to put the mirror back in, and then we have to clean this guy, which is the viewfinder. So that's the one I'm worried about simply because of the frosted back. I'm really not sure. I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to start out with a clean cloth and try that first with a brush and a clean cloth. And then after that, what we'll do is, hey, you can actually kind of see that on the video. Yeah, Jamie, it does, right? The steampunk thing. I'll show you guys a little something else I'm working on. I'm not going to work on this. I might share with you guys what I do to work on this, but look at this guy. This just came to my. This is a Kodak Flashmite Brownie. And it's got three settings, 13, 14, and 15. It's just you know, look at that thing. But this can be actually cleaned up. It's not going to be functional, I don't believe. It does still work, which is amazing to me. But Danielle got this today for 58 cents. So I'm gonna play with it. I'm gonna see what it'll do. Yeah. So we'll see. This will clean up though, so I'll have a lot of fun with that. Anyway, yeah, there's a lot of weird steampunky toys around. You guys usually don't get to see these. This is a Zeiss Icon. I haven't got a chance to work on this one yet, but this is such a cool kind of concept with the face that pops out. I don't remember how to do it. I think I popped it out, and then I'm like, I don't want to touch it because I don't think it'll pop back in. But yeah, so just crazy stuff. This camera actually will not work. Oh, there we go. That's right. You got to pinch it. But watch. Pinch that. Hides away. So I thought that was cool. I was at this rummage sale, and the guy's like, yeah, you can have it. So I just thought it'd be a nice piece for the desk. Nothing that really meant anything to me or anything like that, but I like that steampunk kind of look stuff. So, all right, we got this all good. That's another step. I'm going to set that to the side. We're almost getting ready to put it back together. So the next step for me, though, is this guy. We need to get this clean. So this is kind of unique. It's a magnifier that you flip over, and it magnifies the viewfinder, which is kind of cool. Or if you don't want to magnify the viewfinder, you just flop it down and go with it the way that it is. And it also, I believe, has some sort of other mode or something that it does. Anyway, let's clean this guy. So let's start with the frosted side. And what I'm going to do, generally when there's anything that's got a texture to it and you're not sure if you'll damage it, we don't want to use liquid. Liquid's always the last thing that you want to use. Now, with the lenses, I knew that I was okay. But first off, for cleaning, I'm just going to use a simple brush to clean and see if I can get any dust off this at all. There's still some spots on here. I think they're on the other side, which is cool, because definitely don't want to really put anything on this side. This frosted, it usually doesn't take to liquid very well, and just from previous experience, I can tell you that's not usually a good thing to do. I really like to take it out of here and clean it, but then I don't know if I could get it back in. Not sure how this spring mechanism works, and I don't really, I have no confidence in it at all. So I'm not going to mess with that. I'm going to clean it through here. So we're just going to use a lens pen for this. I think I'm going to brush it all out here. The brushing won't clean it, but it will get the particles out. It'll get them loose, and then I blow it out with the blower. And what that's going to do, essentially, is just when I hit it with the scrubber, I'm not acting like sandpaper. And you should do this with your lenses, too. You should blow the dust off or use the brush to knock all the particles off before you go at it with any sort of cleaning material. Otherwise, you'll scrub it, and you'll end up having streaks and everything else going on, and you don't want to do that. So, all right, this is definitely going to take a wet clean. I can see right now that lens pen is just not doing anything. I'm going to clean this like a sensor. I'm actually going to use a sensor swipe, some pads, and a rubber band. So you're probably saying, well, what if I don't have all these tools? Eclipse is a very common sensor cleaner. You can buy it on Amazon. These are available at Copper Hill Imaging. It's called a sensor swipe. They're very cheap, not expensive. The PEC pads, you can buy them anywhere on Amazon or whatever. A little screwdriver is not going to cost you anything. And the lens pens are available. That's really the only tools that I'm using here. The loop is not really necessary. Everyone should have a blower for their camera. And then I'm just putting that on there like that. That just becomes a little swab. And we wet the swab. Right. And then we're just going to clean this. I'm just going to scrub back and forth. Try to get some of that stuff off there. When you clean a sensor, essentially you paint it like a paintbrush, and then you move it and paint back, and then you move it and paint back. And that's the way you clean a sensor. See, some of the stuff came off there. And we'll see. We'll go back at it with the lens pen. There's one spot left on it. This camera is like the spot camera. It seems like there's one spot on everything. It just won't come off easily. So I'm going to scrub it right in that spot. That might be on the other side too. Don't think it is. Yeah, it's on this side and it seems to be like embedded in there. Oh, I'm getting it. Just be persistent. It's usually just glass. There's nothing special in these old cameras. I just want to make sure I'm not pressing down too hard and going to break it. It's definitely on this side. It definitely will not come off. Now, this doesn't affect the shooting. I mean, this is just me being wanting it cleaned. It won't affect the shooting at all. I mean, this is just what this is what you use to focus and get the image set up. So, all right, looks pretty good. It's so weird when you look at this, you think to yourself, how can that actually work as a viewfinder? But it does, and it's really cool the way it works. The first time I looked in this camera, I was like, oh, that's so cool. I'm going to clean off this little guy. This is just a magnifier that you can use when you're doing your focus. This allows you to kind of see it closer up. So this is glass as well, and you can see how well this pen works on that. I didn't put anything on here as far as cleaner goes. And the carbon in here just cleans that up really nice. All right. So that's pretty much all of the mechanical work that needs to be done. There's still some cleaning that needs to be done. So I'm going to grab a microfiber cloth. I like these closed loop microfiber cloths. They don't get snagged on everything, which is kind of nice, especially for cleaning this kind of stuff. And I usually don't wet it down. It's usually just dust. If it's really bad, like this camera, which is yellowed and melted and has all sorts of problems, I'll usually use 409. 409 works really well. It doesn't hurt plastics. It works nice on plastics. But for a camera like this, it's just basically getting dust off here is all I'm doing. I'm just going to clean that off. Make it look nice. This is not obviously going to be perfect, but, you know, at least we'll be able to take a nice photo with it and see how that comes out. I'm just going to clean out some of this dust. Now, on these matte finishes on the inside of the camera, they're matte so they don't reflect any light. That's because if you reflect light, you're going to get light leaks in your film, and you don't want that. So you should never wet clean any of this. This should all be dry cleaned. So just use a dry cloth to do that. So we're going to put our mirror back in. I think we'll do it in reverse order, so we're going to set that to the side. The very first thing we're going to do, can you believe we reduced the whole camera down to a box? But that's essentially all it really is. So what we're going to do is we're going to put the face back on it. Now I'm going to clean up the face a little bit too, but we're going to put that back together first, and then we'll go ahead. Now I take note, I use these long screws on the bottom. Usually when I'm reassembling, I usually start these by hand. I don't try to use the screwdriver at first. I want to loose fit everything first. A good rule of thumb when you're assembling something to drop a screw. So luckily my eyes still work and I didn't lose it. So yeah, so you want to make sure that you hand tighten this stuff first, and then you'll go back and tighten it down the rest of the way. There we go, we'll get it started. I can see the replay. It's great watching the replay and watching me drop the screw on the floor all over again. All right. So this one in here, I think I have to screwdriver because I can't get my finger on that one. Sometimes my fingers are too big, but I don't tighten it all the way. I'm going to wait and tighten that down. The film in this camera is 120. So you can still get this. There is a website online called The Dark Room. When I went to Joshua Tree, I stole a friend of mine's camera. I didn't really steal it. He let me borrow it, and he said, you know, it's my dad's camera, and I just wonder what you thought of it. I thought I'd let you play with it for a while, see what you think. Well, unbeknownst to him, I took the camera out west, which was the last kind of thing he did with his dad. He went out west. I took the camera out west, and I actually used it in Joshua Tree when I was out there, and I took a bunch of photos and surprised him when I got back home with his dad's camera. And that took 120 film that was converted to 620, which is like a special cartridge that you have to, they have to be, all of the stuff has to be re-rolled. But this takes 120. So it's great that there's a spare roller that I got with it. So I really, all I have to do is go over to thedarkroom.com, buy my film. I want to try some Ilford because I really like the high contrast Ilford film. And I want to buy five or six rolls, man, and just go nuts with it. And then the dark room, those guys will also process it. So that's, you know, that's kind of the cool part of that, is that, that they'll not only sell you the film, but they'll process it as well. And I can get it at B&H. In fact, the last time I bought film, I think I bought it at B&H or Adorama, one of those guys. For his camera, the 620, because I think B&H had a bunch of specially done rolls, which was kind of cool. So, all right. So there's still some cleaning to do around here, and I'll do that once we get things assembled. I get a little nervous when things lay around a little bit too much. I don't want to knock into them when I'm doing this. So I'm going to put the mirror back in. I'm going to clean that off first. And put my magnetic thing back in here. Let's see, this just goes in. So unique. I mean, who thought this stuff up, right? I mean, it's just so cool. All right. Try not to put my fingers on it. My plan, at least. All right. So I've got that on the back there. I'm just holding it. Peace, man. I'm just holding it. And I'm going to kind of press down on my finger. Try not to get my fingerprint on it. Until it gets started. See, it gets started under those two. And then it should slide right in. Slide back in. Please slide back in. Oh, see, it didn't slide back in. So I'm going to use the back of my finger so I don't get a fingerprint out. There we go. And that's it. So it's back in there. You guys can see the lens now where it bounces out. And we're going to put the viewfinder back on top of that. So let's do that. Boom. This goes there. I don't know if you guys, you probably can't see down through the camera. I don't know any way that I can show you the viewfinder. All I can tell you is go find one of these cameras. They're all over the place. You can get them on eBay. They're not expensive. But go take a look through the viewfinder. I'm looking forward to setting this camera down and just taking some photos through the viewfinder. Or also, go check it out on Flickr. If you go to Flickr and you punch in Richoflex, there's a group that shoots this camera, and the pictures are amazing. I mean, they are really good. And that's kind of, you know, once I saw the camera and I saw those photos and what it could do, I was like, man, I got to get this thing working. That was my motivation, get it going. So here's the point where I need a magnetic screwdriver. Magnetic screwdrivers are out in the garage, not where I need them to be. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to start the screw like that. I shall overcome. All right. That going. And as you're having fun watching me be defeated by one little screw, you know I'm going to drop it. At a weird angle with this spring, so I'm having fun trying to get it back in. There we go. All right. That's one. Three more to go. All in all, this is a pretty easy project. A more difficult project and something I need to readdress is I have a lens that I need to take apart. So if you guys ever want to see that, I'd be willing to do a live broadcast of me disassembling a lens. That's always a lot of fun and scary all at the same time, but it's always rewarding taking it apart and then putting it back. Now, I'm not tightening these screws again. Remember, I want to put them in loose, and then I will tighten them all down in a crosshatch pattern once I'm done, just to make sure that it doesn't torque anything the wrong way. Or it's kind of what the manufacturers do when they assemble stuff. So I'm just kind of doing that. As a kid, I built a lot of models. That was my thing. I really loved to build models. I think that kind of carries over. And mostly, when I grew up, we didn't have a whole lot of dough. So if something in my house broke, I had to fix it or I had to go without, one of the two. So I just learned to fix things. Take things apart, find out if they work. Because, I mean, what's the loss there? You throw it away. I mean, that's the loss, right? So try to fix it. All right, so that's one. We'll do the one on the opposite side. Cross tightening. All right. These were definitely not in tight, so if this camera had any light leaks, this will definitely take care of that. These will tighten down nicely now. So. And you don't want to over tighten because it is kind of like a, you know, tin kind of stuff, and you don't really want to reef on it too much. But there we go. That's it. So that's back together. Yeah, let's put the nameplate on it. We'll tie it all up here. I think that went pretty well. Looks pretty good. I'm excited now. I'm going to go, when I'm done here, I'm going to go order my film and get that. I can practice before I go and take it out west with me. I want to make sure I know what I'm doing. I practice with it a little bit, just kind of taking it outside, you know, and dry firing it with no film in it. And it's going to take a little bit. I mean, it's nice because it's got a tripod mount, so that I am actually going to be able to do some landscaping with this. Although, it's a square format, so yeah, my compositions will be a little different, but you know, it'll still be an interesting thing to shoot with, I think. So, all right, so everything's tightened down there. We got everything back together, all clean, and this is the carriage. And oh, you know what I didn't do? This is how you learn, folks. This part, which is the back, supposed to be tucked under there, and it's held down by these. So, this is how you learn stuff. I'm going to see if I can sneak it in there. Because that I kind of screwed up. Without taking it all the way apart, I think I can still get it in there. So we'll find out here in a second. Hate to have to take all those screws out. And do that all over again. Aha! See? Look at that. It lifts up just enough. Stick it under there. I can't stick it under there. Can't stick it under there. All right. We'll try a little bit more. Been a long day today, so doesn't surprise me that I missed that. Okay. There's a felt liner around here. That's all nice and clean. And there's also one on the inside to block the light. That's clean, so I won't even bother with that. There we go. Woohoo! Fits right under there. Okay, so before I do that, though, you can see here that this is kind of dirty, so we're going to clean that. All spiffied up. This thing in the back, the infrared viewer for the film. I really don't want to disassemble it just for that, the look of that. I might take my Dremel tool and use the buffer and see if I can buff it a little bit, but I really don't want to mess with that seal and everything in the back here, because this is where the film slides. And I don't think it's necessary. The window itself is clear and nice, so I don't think I'm going to bother with trying to clean that little lid. That's just be like that. So there we go. It's nice and clean. That up. Pop that back under there. Those two pins in the hinges, and that's what keeps it going. All right, Lori, thanks so much for joining me. I'm going to make this available to other folks once it's produced. So if there's anything you missed at the end, you can definitely check it out later on. It'll be available for everybody to view. So thanks for hanging out, and thanks for the assistance on the audio. Have a great night. Okay, so we're almost there. That, everything's working there. And then safe to put it on its front. A little bit of stuff on the front of the side here. I just want to see if that something off. No, it's just a mark. No biggie. All right. Got that. All right, it's a little dusty in here, so I'm going to dry wipe this out. You can see that when I don't use a liquid, that any of the dust and stuff just comes right out with the microfiber sponge or cloth. And it's much better that way than trying to put a liquid in here. You don't want to damage the matte finish. You want to keep it matte. Otherwise, you're going to have light leaks all over the place. So, yeah, all the dust that was in there came right out. Sorry, I have to lean it up against me to do that, but there we go. Clean in there. So psyched to get some film for this. This would be a lot of fun. Want to definitely do. So there's also, to take note, there's also two film rollers right here. And the film rolls across these. You want to be very careful not to bend those. You also don't want to put any sort of solvent on them. And you just want to wipe them down. Don't get your fingerprints on there. If you touch them with your fingers, then you're going to want to wipe them back down again. Very essential that they spin nice and smooth. And they have absolutely no grease, no anything on them, because that will affect your film. So there we go. It's all cleaned up and nice. There's my auxiliary roller right there, so that snaps in nicely. And we're gonna go ahead and pop that back down in. And there we go. That is it. And that is the Richoflex Model 7. So hopefully you guys thought that was cool and had a lot of fun with that. I'm going to probably spend some time scrubbing around here. You guys, you know, that's a menial task, so you probably don't care to watch me do that. But what I'll do is just I'll take a toothpick or whatever and a swab, maybe a cotton swab, and I'll just go through here and clean all these up. I'll shine them up so that they're nice and clean, and this camera will be ready to go. And so, yeah, $35 project, and it's going to, you know, hopefully have some great returns for me as far as fun and trying something new. Of course, spending some money on some film developing. But, yeah, pretty happy with that. And I got something else done this weekend, which was great. So, all right, guys, thanks so much for joining me. If you want to reach out to me on Hangouts, you guys know how to get to me there. If you're interested in doing a hangout tonight and talking about this, feel free to ring me up. I'll spin around and we'll do a hangout. If not, stay tuned, because I got some cool things planned for Patreon. And we got some cool stuff to happen soon. One of the things is actually having a group hangout at least once a month where we all get together. It's totally casual. Bring your own beer. Bring your own soda. Bring your own water, I don't care, your snacks, your photos, and we just, like we used to do, we'll hang out together, and yes, no screws left over, Jamie, absolutely, that's always a win right there. Secretly, I always just toss those other screws, though, if there's any left. But yeah, I'd like to do that hangout once a month where we all hang out, we talk about photos, and we kind of do that thing we used to always do in the Arcanum. And I think that was highly beneficial for everybody. And show off your new stuff, show off what you're doing, ask questions. We can all kind of talk about things. But yeah, so what is, let me see here. Before I go, I will show you one other thing. This is the shutter release. I'm going to be using this. You've probably seen these, but it screws into here. This really completes the camera, really, when you have this. It's actually off a DSLR, SLR, sorry, film camera. It was off an old, this Shinon that I have here, this old guy. But camera weighs like 5 pounds. That's the shutter release. So very cool. So basically you arm the shutter and press the button. And that's it. So arm the shutter, press the button. And it's really cool because, you know, today in the days of digital, we have all this stuff, right? Well, this is, if you want to do bulb mode, check this out. Put it in bulb mode. Now arm the shutter. And the shutter will stay open. But look, you got this little thing right down here that if you push it up, it holds the shutter button down for bulb mode. So long exposure, right? So that's what I'm looking forward to doing, some long exposure. That's just going to be great. And then when you're done, you just turn this the other way. Watch the pin come up. Turn it the right way. Don't know my own strength. Oh, there we go. Press down on it. And then it closes the shutter. So that's how you do a long exposure with a camera like this. Just like that. So awesome, cool, mechanical stuff. So thanks, guys. I appreciate you hanging out with me. That's going to do it for this broadcast. And stay tuned because I'm sure we'll definitely do another. All right. Thanks, guys. We'll see you again.